The polar vortex is growing, everyone. Not in intensity, in duration. It's going to last a long time. Now, we still have these two snowstorms coming through and ice storms showing a lot of chances for ice. But we're still getting this southern snowstorm that's going to bring a lot more snow and freezing rain after the 10th and the 12th. This is central time up here on top. This is where it's getting a lot of that Gulf moisture, and it will be heavy snow and heavy freezing rain coming with that as well. Now you can see this on Euro as well as GFS as the polar vortex expands out. It actually still breaks apart. We get the sudden stratospheric warming and it breaks apart. But instead of this going back, it comes right back and bottles up towards Canada, keeping the colder temperatures lower into Canada and the lower 48 of the United States. See the same thing with GFS as well. It expands and it actually breaks apart while you get that sudden stratospheric warming event. Then it stays right along the eastern side of the lower 48. And then you can see the northern piece actually comes together with the southern piece instead of the southern piece retracting back. This will keep colder temperatures a lot longer. I want you to remember what I just showed you. So in 4 days, you can see the update with the Euro as we get this below average anomaly coming through, bringing these two snowstorms Wednesday, also for Friday and Saturday. Then it comes in with its below average temperatures. And look how it expands out once we hit Valentine's Day, and it expands and brings in those subzero temperatures all the way towards the southern side, lower 48, all the way into the eastern side of the lower 48. Very cold anomaly coming through. It still needs to retract back and hang out for a little bit before finally leaving out to the north. And we're already on the 17th. This is going to last for quite some time. So look how long this is lasting. This is your lower level temperatures at 850 millibars. As you go Tuesday into Wednesday, you get that snowstorm coming through. This is bringing a lot of cold temperatures. Matter of fact, all the way from Oklahoma all the way across towards North Carolina, you're going to stay potentially in your 20s once you hit around the 10th. Look how it drops down right around the 9th or the 10th, and it stays frozen. But look how it goes even deeper once we go by the 12th through Valentine's Day and beyond, bringing a lot of cold temperatures. All this pink, this is all ridiculously cold temperatures, and it's going to hang out a little longer. It didn't even start its twirl yet that you see in the beginning where it hangs out for a little bit. Latest update with National Weather Service, it did bring that below average anomaly even further across. I think it could still go a little bit further, everyone. And you can see the mixture that's coming with the ensemble. So showing all the way to Wednesday and Thursday, bringing the chance for that freezing rain, also with the snow in the blue. Then as it goes out, you have more coming in for Friday and Saturday on that next system. Definitely a good chance for an ice storm somewhere around northern Illinois, northern Indiana, southern Wisconsin. I will keep you updated as that goes out for Sunday as well. Then it goes even lower. It gets all that precipitation coming in for the Gulf. And look at the mixture that comes in after that. A really bad mixture of freezing rain, snow, and just a mix. Just a sloppy mess in general if you're going to be traveling through this. It is going to get dangerous as you go from the 10th through Valentine's Day for sure. Showing just in the next 5 days, it is going to bring a lot of heavy snowfall towards the higher elevations of California, southern Oregon, also for Washington, higher elevations for Idaho, western Montana, western Wyoming, anywhere from 1 to 2, almost 3 feet or more of snow just in the next 5 days. Also 5 to 9 inches all the way from that blue to pink for northern South Dakota, North Dakota, central to northern Minnesota, northern Wisconsin, northern Michigan, and that's what you see in the ensembles as well. A little bit lighter though, plus a UP, and you can see it will be for New England all the way for the next 5 days. Also bringing on the southern side that freezing rain, the chance for ice storms to come out of that. Almost trending with Euro and GFS, you can see all the heavy snowfall for the Pacific Northwest. All the models is showing feet of snow. It's been showing that. But you see how you have multiple storms coming through the Midwest, according to the Euro. Then you have that southern storm. GFS is showing those multiple storms isn't going to bring a lot, a whole bunch of bangers. It is going to add up to a lot, but it's not going to bring a lot. But it is agreeing to that southern storm as well. This is right after the 10th when that cold air lowers down, and it starts bringing all that precipitation, all that moisture from the Gulf, making this a strong snowstorm, a strong ice storm, a lot of moisture in the cold air. Still the same risk for the snow from the 8th through the 14th. This has not changed in the 8th through the 10th for New England. So look how starting for tomorrow all the way until Thursday, you keep getting the 20s coming on down. All the way from Wyoming, across Nebraska, Missouri, all across Indiana, Illinois, Ohio, northern Kentucky, West Virginia, and out through the Northeast, with sub-zero temperatures still on the northern side of lower 48. Now that is going to hang around all the way until the 10th through the 12th. Then it's going to go even lower. And this is where it stays down all the way from Oklahoma all the way towards Virginia for a few days. You see that? And once you pass Valentine's Day, this is where you get that deeper dash of cold temperatures. And this is where the polar air is coming through and you're waking up around the 15th and 16th, where they're going deeper into Kansas and Oklahoma, feeling like negative temperatures outside all the way through the Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes. And look how it comes down again, just bringing those sub-zero temperatures across, single digits, negative temperatures, and that's where the freezing temperatures come in because it starts hanging around for a long time. Bringing bad wind chills as well for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, stays on the northern tier all the way until Friday. Then it lowers down towards Kansas, all the way towards Virginia. And then once you go towards the 10th, then it goes to Oklahoma. It goes into Texas, goes all the way to the Carolinas. This is your wind chills. This is 11th. This is Tuesday, the 12th, the 13th. Then you have Valentine's Day. This is where the polar temperatures come in. And the wind chills are just ridiculous. Coming all the way down for the 14th, the 15th, for the 16th, just keeping these cold temperatures down. Potentially going all the way towards the south and the southeast with 20s, teens, or even single digits. Hanging around for the 17th as well. This could go on a few more days, everyone. Because just like I showed you in the beginning, if you look here, this is right on the 10th and 11th when it splits. And all the way towards Valentine's Day is still split, everyone. Still bringing those cold temperatures down. Then you go all the way towards the 17th, as far as we was able to see just now. Showing it does pull down and connect with the peace by the U.S., by Canada, and it don't retract back away. Then it hangs out some more. And it still needs to hang out more because it needs to leave. We're already on the 18th. This is going to consolidate and bring colder temperatures longer. Showing that these temperatures could last and it'd be a long duration event, everyone. Where it's going to hang out towards eastern Canada, right over the Great Lakes. And that would keep the polar jet on into lower 48, bringing those colder temperatures. So I will keep you updated. Thank you so much for your time, all your help and support, everyone. I'll see you first thing in the morning. Now before I go, Matthew 10, 16 and 17. Stay sharp, everyone. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. But be aware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Get ready for these cold temperatures. They're going to be hanging around for quite some time and get colder and colder the longer we go into February. I will see you first thing in the morning. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope He keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great night, everybody.